This week, I got started playing around with Raycast and Reflect. Now, I know I'm a little bit behind the wagon here, but I thought I'd get myself caught up. So this first video is going to be focusing on how to get Raycast set up and start using some basic functions with Reflect. And then I think in some videos afterwards, I'm going to do some more complex workflows where I maybe use some of the AI features in Raycast, use some of the other extensions in tandem with it and other workflows. So if you're someone that either already uses Raycast with Reflect or you've found some really, really cool workflows with it, please let me know in the comments and I will add it to the next video. But to get started here, we are going to begin just on the Raycast website. You can go ahead and download it for Mac, which I'm assuming most people are using with Reflect since it's a pretty Apple heavy product. And once you download it, you can pull it up using command space. That's the set shortcut. And this is Raycast. This is what it looks like right out of the box. So here I don't have any of the extensions downloaded. These are just, you can see the applications here that I can just kind of open with a shortcut. So right off the bat, if I want to, I can type in Reflect and use that to just open Reflect. That's just kind of the basic shortcut open. So if I'm here in Chrome, I can do command space and just quickly open Reflect. And that's pretty a basic one that, to be honest, isn't particularly helpful because you can use, I think it's called Apple's native Spotlight to do that anyway. So what I recommend doing pretty much right off the bat is downloading the Reflect extension. So if I type in extension, I can click on that and it pulls up this page here. And here I can go download the Reflect extension. And by the way, there's a lot of other stuff you should explore that Raycast can do. It's a really incredible tool. So there's a lot of like, I don't know, the clipboard one, actually clipboard history is one of my favorite ones, so that you can paste in things that you copy, multiple times before, not just the most recent one. Quick links is nice. The emoji, kind of search tool. So there's a lot of cool stuff, play around with it, but I'll just focus on Reflect for this one. So to add the extension, click on this plus sign here, and we're going to install from the store. So I can just type in Reflect here and I will click on that and this looks like it. So you can kind of read through some of the commands here. I'm going to go over these and show you, but I'll kind of run through them here since it gives a description. So you can append to a daily note. You can do a quick append. So it just kind of does it directly via the command line. You can create a new note. You can immediately open search. You can navigate directly to the daily note. And I actually think that these, they're all pretty useful. I've been using it basically, you know what? I'm just going to show you. Let me install this first. I'm getting ahead of myself. So I'm going to install the extension here. It's very fast. There, we're good to go. I can now, kind of exit out of this. And if I go actually now back into the settings, I can see, the Reflect extension here. And if I click on that dropdown, you can see all of the commands there. So now the extension's ready to go. And so if I pull up the same Raycast command and type in Reflect, you now see all of these other ones. And by the way, this shortcut is just a shortcut that I have generally set up to use. It's not actually related to Raycast at all. So I'll kind of go through a couple examples here. So let's say that we want to append something to my daily note. Oh, this is a good step. So fortunately, I don't really need to discuss this because it's just going to prompt you to do it just like it did there. But make sure you go in and actually connect and authorize it with your Reflect account. And so it's going to kind of ask, you know, which one, if you're already signed in, it might do it automatically like that. And then you'll be able to select which graph you want to append to. So I didn't really come up with an example for this one, but let's say it's just something I want to log in my note. So I'm going to say, went on a early morning walk and felt much more relaxed than normal after. And let's say, you know, we're doing this as a daily log. So I'm going to prepend the timestamp, which is honestly one of the coolest features of this. If you're someone that likes to do daily logs and actually keep it by the time, this will do it for you automatically if you just check that box. I'm going to keep it as 12 hour because I'm American. I'm not going to do anything with the parent list and the graph. Oh no, which one did I do? It was my demo brain. I might have to do that over again now. Shucks. Okay. Oh, no. Pulled it up. Nice. Okay. Demo brain. There we go. And submit. And that's it. So you can see you can do all of that without ever entering the Reflect. So if I'm here in a browser page or if I'm on Slack or something, you can just do it directly without having to toggle applications, which is really incredible because most people, I think, experience this sensation when you switch screens. It almost like it feels like your brain is an Etch-a-Sketch, those toys you had as a kid. And when you switch a screen, it's almost like you shake the Etch-a-Sketch and it just kind of like gets fuzzy the more screens you toggle. And all of a sudden you're like, wait, what was I even doing? It's sort of like when you need to do a task in a room and you enter the room and all of a sudden you're like, why did I come in here? This eliminates all of that. It's super, super cool. So now if I go back into my demo brain here, I see I've got a timestamp here and I have the action item. So God, that's so amazing that you can just kind of, you know, do that in one line. Also to give kind of another example, you could use this in tandem with the tool like Super Whisper and do it via voice for something like your daily log. So if we type in Reflect and we want to do the same append to a daily note, in my note here, I can say, I went on a sunrise walk this morning, and even though it was really cold, I felt extremely relaxed and positive afterwards, and it's something that I want to do every day. Then I can stop my recording. You actually can't see my Super Whisper log outside of the window there, but I can just paste that in, still click the timestamp, put it in the demo brain. And that's kind of nice because then you do the same append, and it'll probably show up here in a second. But because I use the voice tool for it, look at how much more context I could include. So I did it in less time, but included way more context. So again, that's another tool that's not in Raycast, that's Super Whisper, but I do think that they work really well in tandem. I think I'm going to focus on that one in the next video as one of the workflows. Okay, you could probably also see that there's some other commands here. So the quick append is very similar. It's just that instead of opening that note page, it just goes right into whatever you want to write here. So, you know, I'm just going to write that in there. To give kind of a quick example. And oh, then it makes you put in the ID. So anyway, it's basically the same format of, you know, what was done before. Now, I think on the next category that I think this is my next favorite one. So if I pull up that up again, type in Reflect just so that we can see all the commands. The search notes one, that is one of my favorites because if I'm trying to think of something that I referenced, whether it's like a meeting or an idea I had, or maybe notes I took out of like a book or an article or something, you can just click that command and it goes straight into your search page here. And, you know, then you can kind of go down and navigate to wherever you want, especially with the new advanced search feature. So super cool. Just to kind of highlight the other ones. New note creating, that's just what it sounds like. If you hit that one, it's just going to open Reflect and create a new note for you. There is the daily notes that, again, same thing. Instead of just opening it, it will open it directly to the daily notes page. And I think that there will be more added here and whatnot. So these are kind of the essential commands you can do with the extension right out of the box. I recommend starting there, trying and getting used to those, playing around with it a little bit, and then start playing around with some more advanced workflows. So that's kind of what the next video will be covering with Raycast. But it's a really, really cool tool. If you're someone that is, you know, someone that likes to move fast, you're really into efficiency, really into kind of keyboard shortcuts and that way of working, this is something that you are definitely going to love. So enjoy. And again, don't forget to share in the comments what workflows you guys are using with Raycast.